طبعا الآن من مالي إلى إلى النرويج إن شاء الله، وهذه هي طبيعة هذا المؤتمر المبارك. جال أجا توري رئيس مجلس إدارة التحالف المسيحي بالنرويج، وليأتي لنا بما عنده.
Brothers and sisters, I'm so privileged to be here in this great gathering, and being here this morning and also now has been a feast of listening to deeply held convictions and experiences that you are making together in your nations and in our nations of the world. I was very impacted through the years by the role of Egypt as a leader in bringing peace and establishing and sustaining peace through the great men like Sadat and Mubarak and Sisi and many others. So I commend you for the role you have as bringing stable peace and sustainability in the world, and particularly in the greater Middle Eastern region. Dialogue is so important, but dialogue is more listening than speaking. When we dialogue, we need to spend much more time in hearing the other and also hearing the heart of the other. I noted this morning in a speech by Professor Gamal, he made a strong statement about women, and I was so happy. I'm the father of six. I have three boys and three girls, and I love my boys, but I also love my girls. And I believe that when we give a future for the boys and the girls, that is a great contribution to peace in the home, in the family, in our societies, and between our nations. And women bring something into our lives that men cannot bring. They bring the wisdom from their motherhood, from their womanhood, and we need to listen and heed what they share with us. I also noted the distinguished, I don't know the name, from Jordan, right? My friend who spoke here this morning about the dignity, the honor of every human being. That's so important. The dignity and honor of everyone which God gave us upon birth. God created man and woman. The Bible has a strong statement about the importance of manhood and womanhood based in creation. God created us, and we need to adhere to what God has done. He did not only create women, he did not only create men, but he created both of us. And we are to be together in marriage, but also in friendship and in wisdom and in cooperation. May I propose that we may find common ground, Muslims and Christians and other faiths, where we base our common ground on creation. God created. God made man. He made woman. And I believe when we establish this in our hearts, in our mind, and even in the political life, we will see so much more peace and harmony. In my Christian circles, I speak about the creation mandate of the Bible, and I'm sure that is totally within the message of the Quran, the Holy Quran, and I think we can meet and join each other in this strong basis. When we establish common ground through creation, the honor of every man and woman, and respect for faith, respect for your faith, not just for my faith, but for your faith. And when I respect, I not only respect your opportunity to have a faith, but I will even respect and honor that you are sincere, that you really have something that I need to listen to. That, I believe, should become a part of our common ground. I speak to them as a father. I have six children. blessed children. Three boys, three girls. But in a Western society, in Norway, one of the most secular nations in the world, the most difficult nation to live in. I'm a priest, a pastor. I have strong convictions. I believe in the Bible. And I understand your faith in the Quran, because I believe in the Bible. I know how important that is for you and for me. But as I've raised my family, one of my sons is an atheist and is anti-Christian. He's anti-Muslim also. One of my daughters is becoming a priest in the state church, and she's a liberal priest. She believes in homosexuality. And I cry to God, God, I've made mistakes. How could this happen? But you know, in this pluralistic society, it is so difficult. But how shall we live together? I think my friends, my brothers and sisters, we need to stick to our convictions. Believe in the Quran. Believe in the Bible. Believe in our holy leaders. But let's also find peace with a son who's an atheist. Find peace with my daughter who's a liberal theologian. I need to respect. I don't agree, but I love them. And love is a power from God. Love is in your religion. Love is in my religion. Love is a force. And when we love people, we will respect them, and we will be patient, and one day we will come together. Love carries through everything. Thank you so much, precious friends, brothers and sisters, for allowing me, a Christian pastor from Norway, to be among you, and I feel that I'm among family and friends. Thank you so much. God bless you all.